I think Bo Burnham's Inside is like a masterclass in DIY video production. So I'd like to go through it bit by bit and explain how I think he pulled everything off from a technical standpoint. I don't want to get into like the creative or the meaning of it all. So hopefully if you were inspired by the special and you want to make some cool stuff like that, a lot of the equipment he used, I'll even link to like Amazon's. It's cheap stuff. And he just used a lot of creativity and hard work to like make a really impressive product. So with that said, I'm just going to start from the beginning and work my way through. Okay, so this first shot of the whole thing, I actually think, because if you look at his hair and beard, they're short. I actually think he shot this at the end. And this is one of the things where I'm being a little presumptuous. He would have had to have a lot of foresight to know what the whole work was going to look like. And it's something that ended up taking him like a year to make, right? To know that he would need this particular shot. And I don't think he would have known that the pandemic would last as long as it did. Like for most of the rest of the special, if you look around, he never really has short hair like that anywhere else. If he shot this at the beginning, it would imply that he made this shot and then didn't really shoot anything for like another, I don't know, 2-3 months, however long it takes to get your hair that long. And that just seems unlikely. Okay, so this first shot here, he is being lit by this little LED panel, probably something like this. These are pretty cheap to get. This is two of them that come with stands and these filters and stuff. And so that's the only light on him at the moment. And then he turns on this headlamp and he points the headlamp at a disco ball that's up here. And that, if you know how a disco ball works, the light bounces off and the disco ball is spinning and it just shoots the lights all over. And that's a really cool effect to get for probably really cheap. How much does a disco ball cost? Okay, so you got a choice of disco balls, $16, $14. And headlamps are also pretty cheap. This one comes with batteries. So here, as the camera moves out, the camera itself isn't moving. It's done in post-production. It's digitally zooming out. So like this is what he actually shot, something like this wide. And then he just cropped it in and then zoomed it out. And you can tell because of like perspective. So like, you know, this piece of furniture here and the trim here and the wall and the keyboard, all of these things, they keep their same distance from each other as you move in and out. And if the camera was actually moving, the spaces between objects changes. An easy way to think about this is to like pull out your phone, put it about a foot from your face, look at something slightly above the phone, and then move your face closer to it. And you'll see that now I can't see that thing because my face is closer to the phone, and so my angle of view is not as wide. God, this is not a great way of explaining this. But the point is, as you move forward and backwards, the distance between objects changes because the angle at which you're viewing them changes. That's what happens when you actually move a camera in and out. That's never happening in any of the shots where it seems to go in and out. The only other way to do it is if he had a zoom lens and like a machine on the lens that was zooming it for him and keeping focus, but I'm gonna go ahead and bet he didn't do that. He just did it in post. And he did shoot it, I think, in 4K. We'll talk about the camera in a second. And when you're shooting in 4K, you can zoom in a lot and not lose a lot of resolution. Here, there are some random shots of him setting up and stuff, so it gives us a little bit of behind the scenes. This tape measure, people use that to measure how far you have to focus the lens. I mean, I've never done that. I usually just like use my eyeballs. Or there's autofocus, or you can use a remote on your camera to focus. Okay, so here you see the monitor. This is what he's looking at, which it shows what the camera is recording so that he can see it. This is just a light. He's just adjusting it. So he's adjusting the light while looking at the monitor. And you'll see both of those things come up a lot through the special. Here he's messing with some lights from his iPad. I think this actually looks like he put in like smart lights into his overhead lights. I don't think he ever used that throughout the special, but I think that's what it is because it looks like the light, it looks like the light's coming down from above. You can see him here putting on his in-ear monitors. These are like headphones that go inside of your ears. He uses those a few times. In this shot, you actually see his like audio monitors. These are what you listen to when you're recording and mixing music and stuff. So I don't know if he doesn't really show himself making the music ever. He shows himself making the videos, shows the lights and all that stuff, but he doesn't ever show himself like sitting down writing songs. So I'm guessing he recorded a lot of the music in the same room, maybe on this desk. I don't know. Maybe he has another studio where he actually does the recording. Here you see the camera for the first time. So this seems to be the camera that he used to record, and it's probably the most expensive gear used on the whole project. It's a Panasonic S1H. I don't know what kind of lenses he uses. He does, you could see a few different lenses throughout the special, and those might be expensive too. This camera shoots in 6K. I don't think he shot in 6K because that would be like really heavy footage to deal with, and I don't think it's necessary. I would guess he probably shot in 4K. It's even possible he shot it in 1080. Sometimes he's zoomed zoomed in and it's pretty grainy, but I would bet he shot it in 4K because you could also do slow motion in 4K on this camera, and there is a good amount of slow motion in this special. So here he turns on a spotlight. You could see he turns it on with this remote right there. I'm not exactly sure how that works. I'm not a lighting person. I don't know what exactly the remote is doing, if it's specifically turning on that light or if he has something that the remote controls that turns on lights. But this is a spotlight. I'm sure you know what a spotlight is. It's like a circular, real sharp light. So here we kind of get to the first tricky thing, because you're seeing him play and sing, and we're assuming that we're hearing what he's actually playing and singing, that he's not like lip syncing. But then you get this camera change to here, right? But there was no like other camera over here to get that shot. So I don't think he ever used more than one camera throughout the whole thing. I think he just moved the camera and then shot that other part. So you're hearing him live. Then he switches over here. And if we're still hearing him live on the microphone, like he's not lip syncing now, he has to make that noise, wait for this pre-recorded thing to happen. But he doesn't have any headphones on, so I don't know. He maybe just has it on speakers and he's assuming it's going to bleed into the mic and that doesn't matter. And then here he goes back to talking and singing, right? And then all this music that's happening under. I'm assuming that when he's talking, he's not like listening to the synthesizer. He just knows how long he has to talk for this bit. And here he does something that's like good for continuity, but it's fake because he reaches down, right? Like he's reaching for this thing that he's reaching for over here. But you know that he moved and set up the camera and did it again. He just had it pre-planned. That's just the kind of shit you do when you're well rehearsed. So now he reaches down, picks up a remote, turns on a projector with it. So he turns off the spotlight and turns on the projector with the remote. And then he slips the remote in his pocket like a sneaky magician. And so now the projector is shining on the background and on his face. The question here is, how is he lip syncing? Because, right, he's singing to the beat, but he doesn't have any way of listening. He has no headphones on or no in-ear monitors. Sometimes you see like a headphone wire coming off of him. So it could be that he's not actually singing. He's just listening to speakers and it's pre-recorded. Or it's coming through speakers and he just doesn't care that a little bit of the audio is bleeding into the mic. That's possible, but he doesn't do it other times. And in the rest of this video, like all of this stuff, this is all just like making a music video where you're lip syncing along to a track that's playing in the background. So you just say, okay, play the music. And then you just move your mouth like you're singing. Like here, he's obviously not, you're not seeing him singing the recording, right? I mean, that should be pretty clear. On this shot, I don't know if this shadow is caused by the light bouncing off the table and then bouncing back on his face, and that's what's illuminating him and creating the shadow. But like these shadows are really weird. Like they imply that there's like two light sources, so there might be somewhere hidden there another little like LED panel. Here he just set up this crazy DJ light and the spotlight behind him, and I would bet he's not actually singing here and this is lip syncing. Here's a cool shot of some blinds. Okay, here we see the camera again. The microphone that he uses a lot is an SM58. It's like the most common live recording microphone. I think the reason he uses a couple dynamic microphones versus condenser microphones is he's in a big empty room with a lot of echo, and it'll just capture the sound of his voice more than the sound of the room. It's also really annoying that he didn't set the clock on his stove. Keeps blinking. He's also missing a screw here on the light plate. A little annoying. Okay, so here he swings over and you can get a glimpse of some of the equipment. This is that video monitor that I mentioned before. I'm pretty sure it's this one, and it's like $100. And this just allows you to see, because when you're using a camera, sometimes there's like a little screen, or sometimes the camera's facing the other direction. And this just allows you to see what you're recording. Like you can see here, this is what the camera is seeing. And in fact, inside of this screen, there's another little screen. And inside of that one, there's probably another little screen. So here you have his audio interface for his mic. That's like a Focusrite Scarlett. That's where he plugs in his microphone and that goes into his computer. You can see he's recording on Logic Pro. This thing here is the lighting mixer thing. I don't know really anything about lighting. I just know that that's what that one is. I found this one. This is almost certainly it. Yeah, that's definitely it. I guess it's an older one, so they don't sell it anymore, but $150. Over here, you have a projector. I don't know if this is the... This looks like one of those cheap projectors you can get on Amazon, and then you get them and they're only like 640p. I think he probably got a more powerful projector, and you can kind of see it later because some of the stuff looks really good and really sharp on such a big wall. So he might have just gotten this one to test stuff out and then used a better one later on, but maybe not. Maybe this is the one used. So when you see stuff like this, like everything looks blue, that could be lighting, or it could have just been shot like normal and then you just do it in color correction, and you can see him looking at himself in the camera monitor in front of his face. This whole song is just like a regular music video. You can see he's just lip syncing obviously to the song. He has it on playback. It's like pretty standard music video. Like, I don't think you're supposed to expect that he's singing this live right now. I don't know how much to add to these, like, you know, they're just pretty much straight up music videos, right? So what you do is you just set up the camera in a bunch of different angles like these, and then you just record either yourself doing a short little thing, or you record yourself like singing the whole song, so you have a shot of your mouth moving to that part, and then you just edit it all together in a way that looks cool. This is one of those shots that I don't think is an actual like behind the scenes capture, because like why would he be recording himself like opening his laptop and like looking at the macOS Catalina background, right? Like what is this a behind the scenes of? I think he set it up because it's just like an interesting little interlude. Okay, so here we get to one that is really interesting. So how did he light this? So he has the spotlight on him. You can see by the big circle and the hard shadow of his, you know, body. The background is being lit by two lights. This one here, which is a big LED panel, and then this one here as well. Okay, here's one of those LED lights. They're like $90 each. Sometimes they come in like two packs. I'm actually using one very similar to this right now to record my face. They probably have filters on them to give this one like a yellowish color, this one like a more red color. And they're pointed like behind him, so the light isn't shining on him as much, right? They're mostly pointed at the walls. So here you're almost certainly hearing him play the piano and sing, and that's what you're seeing, what you're hearing. But here he switches to the other shot. You see how he did that, where he starts turning his head as if he's going to look at another camera. That camera wasn't there, okay? He just knew ahead of time that that's where it was going to be. He just knows how to, you know, edit to make things look like continuous shots. So now he's not playing, but we still hear the keyboard sound, right? So we know that he's just listening to the playback. And I'm guessing that he pre-recorded all the Sako parts, obviously, because he's not moving his mouth when Sako talks. And he's listening to the keyboards, and then he's just singing along. And so we're hearing the recording of his vocals, but everything else is playback, right? Like the Sako was pre-recorded and he's hearing Sako, and then, you know, this is just like rehearsing, right? He has these little bits where he's going to talk, and if he talks too quickly, then there's going to be a weird like pause before Sako talks. If he talks too long, he's going to be talking over Sako, so he has to like rehearse it so the timing is correct. And that's why this kind of shit probably took forever. So here I think we're seeing him sing, and we're hearing that, and everything else, all the music, there's like drums, keyboard, Sako, all that's pre-recorded. And you know, there's a lot of private property here, by the way, Bo. Just saying. This whole thing, he has this softbox on the light that he doesn't use any other time that I can think of, and that's just his main light, and then he has this little fill light, and then he has this backdrop, which all of this stuff is so goddamn cheap these days. This stuff really didn't exist like 5 years ago. All of these lighting and backdrop stuff used to be so expensive. So you see a lot of these kind of packages. This is for a green screen, but sometimes they sell them with like multicolored backgrounds. It comes with like the whole package, and there are three clips that come with it, and I noticed that he is using one, two, probably three clips. So he's almost certainly using something like this. He's also using like a wireless lav mic. You can see there's the like receiver. There you can see the microphone. Okay, White Woman's Instagram. This one is a lot like a music video. There's only one time, which is right here, where he's like singing into a microphone and he's got the headphones on, but I don't think he's actually recording any of this. Like, I don't think he would be recording with this mic in that room, like for the reasons I mentioned. It would be really echoey and stuff. I think he's just lip syncing all of this. And then throughout the rest of the video, like here, like obviously he's not, you're not seeing him singing the actual audio there, just, you know, regular music video stuff. I love that he had to like buy all these freaking shirts just for like 3 seconds of footage. And this right here probably took so much goddamn time, hanging up all these freaking lights like around the AC unit and around the window, like goddamn. That must have been very tedious. It's just all setting up for each one of these shots. All the props, all the different outfits and stuff. That's probably what took the longest on that. Here's just him watching the previous video. He's being lit by the light from the laptop and reflected on the whiteboard over here. Just a cool looking shot. Here's like another random interlude shot. You can see the big spotlight here that comes up a few times. I think this is also a spotlight there, and there's a reason why I think this one is actually the one he uses most of the time, and this one just looks really cool. And I'll show you later why I think that is. Here he's just sitting on the stool and he's got the spotlight on him. Not that much interesting going on. Then you switch to the intern song, and it's funny because it's kind of the same thing. It's him probably sitting on that stool with the spotlight on him and nothing else. And making something black and white, you just do that in post-production. I don't. Sometimes people go black and white in the camera. I don't know why you would do that. Okay, so the reaction to the reaction to the reaction video. This one, as one, I have to kind of assume how he did it. But he can kind of cheat here. Let me move my camera. Because he has an excuse to look at the computer, right? He's like reacting to what's on the screen. And I think whatever's on the computer is giving him a cue for when each loop ends and the next one begins. So I think he probably just had the video, the previous intern video, playing on the computer, and it's just looped. He knows he has to make like three little rants, and he has X amount of time for each one. I'm sure he rehearsed them a few times to know that he's generally in that ballpark. And then as he sees the video winding down, he kind of like, okay, I got to finish this rant. And then it starts again, and he knows now he's doing the next rant. The point is, when he gets to these parts, he's not actually watching himself react to the reaction, obviously, because he's recording it, and he would have had to remove the data from the camera, put it on the computer, and that's not what happened. So I think he is actually watching this video on loop, or maybe he just has a clock that he knows how long this video lasts for, and he just has to practice the each little rant to time it right. And once everything's recorded, he just cuts that snippet of the first rant and he puts it here in the corner. And then the second one, he puts it, you know, here. And they're just three videos stacked on top of each other. Actually, in this point, it's four. But that last rant, he just cuts it short. Okay, sick. The Jeffrey Bezos songs are probably my favorite songs. So this one, very cool, very easy lighting technique that is looks awesome and very easy to do. So again, the little zoom out is digital. It's happening in post. Not sure why he had the fan on in this one. It just looks kind of cool, I guess. So what he's doing is he has that LED panel kind of like from that very first song. You get a silhouette from when the light is on the other side of the camera. So if like the light is here and the camera is here, the camera doesn't see the light. It just sees the light that goes around my face. Right, and that's what's happening. You're seeing the light that's going around him, but you're not seeing the light on our side, and so that's how you get silhouettes. But he doesn't point the light at himself because then the background would be dark, right? Because the light wouldn't be pointing there. And to really give you that contrast, to make the background really bright and him really dark, he points the light at the wall. The light bounces off the wall and then comes back and creates the silhouette. And that's a trick I don't think a lot of people realize. This is what I'm actually doing right now. My light that's on me right now is not pointed at me. It's pointed at the wall, and because most people have white walls, or you could even put up a white piece of styrofoam or something. It's very common to bounce light off of stuff. Like, you think you have to point a light at things to illuminate them, but bouncing light off of stuff is very common. It's used for getting really soft light, because then the light, like, you know, it bounces off the wall and then scatters all over the place. Very easy trick that looks very cool, and this synth is fucking sick. Okay, on this part, he just set up a camera. He has his video monitor here. You can see, and he was probably just like laying down and then like looking at it to make sure the shot's good. And then, you know, went ahead and did the thing that he was prepared to say. I think he probably just scattered a bunch of this stuff to represent what it's like to make a bunch of video projects by yourself. Just cables and batteries and battery charger. There's a football over here and like a wrench. I don't think those are actually things that were there. I don't think this paper towel roll was naturally there. He probably set that stuff up. But I think it represents the mess that this room was in for a lot of the recording. Okay, for the sexting song, everything you're seeing is from the projector. You could just see the big square of the projector, and that's what all the light is coming from. Projectors, you put out a good amount of light, so he doesn't need any lights on him. Also, the AC is set to 69, which the rest of the whole special, the AC is never on, and it's in LA, and I've lived there, and it gets really hot, so I guess he had to just like turn it off when he was recording. I don't know. This is another one that's like obviously just like a regular music video where he's lip syncing. You're not, you know, seeing him recording. And with stuff like this, the projection is just playing back a video, and he's just standing in front of the video, and it's time to the music. So I actually jumped to the very end. There's a snippet at the very end where he shows some more of the behind the scenes stuff. He just had everything in Final Cut Pro. He didn't even like export the video before going to the projector. He probably just hooked his laptop right into the projector. And so you can see this is the music track here. This is the white background, and then all of these little purple guys are all the text. He's also got a folder on his desktop called Drake. So like all of these words and stuff, it's just Final Cut Pro, playing that video file to the projector, and the music is also synced up to it. So he's listening to the audio from Final Cut Pro, and that's how he, you know, lip syncs along to the music, and it also syncs up with the words and what's on the screen. All of this stuff is just the projector on his face. So like, you just set up the camera and you record these different angles, right? Like this one, and then he's singing here, and then he, like, but did he record the entire song from this angle, or did he just record little parts? Like, because then you would end up recording the entire song like 50 times. So you have every lyric in every angle. And probably he planned a little bit so he wouldn't have to do that. So this shot is pretty cool. The background is obviously very green, but he is lit, you know, normal. So he just has a light somewhere behind him. You can't see it, probably pointed at that wall. And that wall just reflects green all over the walls. And then he has a ring light. You can see by the reflection in his eye, actually. It's like a circular light that people use. I don't know. It's like a kind of like a beauty light that you put like the camera in the middle of the ring. So you're like looking right into the light. I think he used that because this is like a, you know, YouTube speaking into the camera thing. And those people love to use ring lights. So here he is playing on the MIDI keyboard. These kind of keyboards don't have any sounds built in. I think the other one he uses has like built-in piano sounds, and it looks like a more substantial instrument. Like it probably has weighted keys to make it feel like a real piano. This is just controlling like a Wurlitzer sound on his laptop here. And so, yeah, the audio is being recorded from his vocals on this little microphone on the headset. Like, why did he do that? And he didn't just like set up a microphone. I think he just bought a bunch of weird shit and likes to mix it up to give it a different visual look. You can see some different camera lenses here. Camera lenses can be expensive, so it could be that like each of these lenses is like $10,000. Here you see one of the lights that you're going to see a little bit more of, and this one too. These are part of the ones that do the crazy, more colorful stuff. Another little zoom here, and this was definitely recorded. You know, you're seeing what you're hearing. He looks up at the monitor. I'm betting the monitor is like right off screen. This is just him sitting in front of the projector. I'm betting that the light from the projector is bouncing off the wall and then on his face. So here, like, the projector can't be behind him, or else like he would be lit up here, which means it has to be in front of him so he stays dark. But to keep it at like this angle, like where is it, right? It could be like down here, like at his feet, but then it'd be hard to keep this like perfectly square projection image. So probably it's like up here, and it would look really awkward if we could see what was actually happening. Like he has like a projector like right at his chest. This song is another music video, right? Just lip syncing to the pre-recorded music. It looks like he used like smoke machines to give it a, you know, sexy feel. So here you can actually see he is holding the monitor in his hand. Which he doesn't really show any other recording gear the rest of this video, and that slipped in, and he left it in because sometimes, you know, who cares? To get an effect like this, I mean, he could have maybe done it with the projector, where he just creates a white cross on the projector, and then so the black doesn't project anything, but I don't think that's how he did it. What you can do is you just get a spotlight, and then you put like a piece of cardboard, and you cut like a little cross into the cardboard, and you put the cardboard right in front of the spotlight, and that's the shape that shines through. Okay, so here he's turning on the smoke machine that I sort of predicted in the last shot. You can see all the smoke and how it looks like in the light. He turns on the fan to help blow it around. He's pushing it around with his hand to make it more even. And you can see it's like a really cool looking effect you can get. Makes things look really sexy and smoky. And yeah, you can get a smoke machine for $36. Delivered tomorrow. I've seen a lot of people speculating about whether this like camera drop was real or not. This has happened to me a lot of times. I'm sure this happened to him many times while he was filming, that things like they're all connected with cables and your headphones, you stand up and you forget your headphones. Maybe this particular shot was set up, but I'm sure that that actually did happen to him. Okay, so here you can see he turns on the light with a little remote that's in his hand there. There is like light coming from outside the window, so it's possible it's daylight outside and this is totally fake. Or maybe that's just like a porch light or something. Either way, he very easily could have faked this, right? Just reset the clock to 11:58 and then record it a few times. But maybe it's real. Whatever. Doesn't mean he didn't feel what he's saying. It's kind of interesting that the spotlight is pointed at the clock, right? Not at him. I don't know what that means. Okay, this one's pretty cool because all the lighting stuff plus his vocals is all happening live and he's controlling it. So this one is probably one of the best of like just solid performance because it's all one shot too. So these lights, okay, hold on. This light here is creating this purple pink kind of light, and that's what's making him look pink and creating this shadow. And these are lights that can be any color you want, pretty much. The little white light behind him is a little LED light. that he is holding against his butt. Right there, he's holding against his butt so you don't see any light. And then he flicks it out, and it illuminates the back. And that's just like a super creative little trick. I don't know if that's a... It almost looks like it's a phone, but it's really small. Maybe it's just a really small LED panel. And you can see here, he steps on a pedal right here. And that turns off this light. And then he just uses this little LED light to do circles around his head to create this cool effect. And you can see the three pedals there. There's one, two, and three. And so this right pedal is controlling this light. The left pedal controls this light over here. And the middle pedal controls a light that's like below us, but pointing straight at him. Here you'll see him hit that pedal again. Right there. And so that turned that light on, and now he puts the light back behind his butt. And so now he turns the right one off, and he turns the left one on. Right? And that's this light, creating this shadow. Turns the middle one on, now he's got that middle light. And now he's gonna turn all three of them on. And so now all three lights are on, three shadows, and they look like his cool background singers. White light is still pointed at his butt. He turns off all three, and now he does something similar to like the Jeff Bezos number one song, where he points the light at the wall. The light illuminates the wall, making it really white and bright. The wall bounces off and then creates this silhouette. Another interesting thing right there, you can see the headphone cable between his legs. So those are his in-ear headphones, right? They're like headphones that go inside your ear. So you can't see them because his hair is covering them, but you can see the cable going back here. It's probably going to his laptop. His laptop is playing back everything except for the lead vocals because that's what he is recording. And so it allows him to hear it and sing along to it. So like, why did he use the cable again? Why did he use the in-ear monitors instead of like the big headphones? Probably because he's like half naked and wants to, you know, seem like he has less on. I like this part because he says, check that one, let's do one more. And that's the kind of, that's just like him talking to himself. Here you can see they're the in-ear headphones. He took them out. This shot, nothing particularly special about this shot. Unless he filmed it with him so low in the shot, which, you know, it is a little bit, it's a lot of like headroom up here. It's possibly shot it because he knew he was going to do this and he wanted it to fit on his shirt, but also like illuminate his whole face. That's a kind of a stretch because it looks like he did this, several months later. But it does work out perfectly, right? Because if he didn't have all that headroom, his face would be like up here. Or maybe it's all a sham and he went back and recorded this after. He cut his hair like halfway back to short. Who knows? He's also wearing that lavalier mic in that video. Probably because he wants it to look like an interview, kind of like the other one. And when you sit down for an interview, they usually give you a lav mic. Okay, the intermission. How do you do this? He probably just got a piece of glass. Where do you get glass? Okay, you can just buy like a pane of glass on Amazon for 13 bucks. So he just puts a piece of glass in between him and the camera, obviously. One interesting thing is that he's focused on like the bubbles, which means that he's out of focus. He could have had himself in focus, but it's kind of interesting. What I love is that he had to buy this whole like custodian outfit just for this one shot. So here it's just this one spotlight on him. He has a different mic. I don't know if he's used this microphone before and I missed it. Before he was using like an SM58, which is a microphone used for live vocals a lot. This is an RE20. This is what it looks like. This one comes with a bunch of stuff. It's usually used for like broadcast and like radio stuff, but a lot of people do use it for vocals, and it's a dynamic mic also, so it doesn't capture a lot of the room sound. He used it back on the intern video. Here you can pretty clearly see it. I think he went with this one because it's a little more old-timey looking, and he was going for this like Ray Charles thing. I'm guessing that, yeah, like which microphone he uses for which songs. A lot of it is just like to keep it visually interesting to switch it up. Because usually when you know what kind of mic you like for your voice, you know, you just kind of stick to that one. Okay, the Twitch streamer one. Let me move my camera. It's funny because this is kind of like exactly what's happening now, right? I'm a person inside of the video. Okay, so he had to either record this part first or this part first, right? I think he recorded this one first, because it just seems easier to manage that way. Like, he just records himself, you know, walking around and doing stuff. I mean, he obviously pre-wrote the whole thing. He kind of just does the actions that he knows he needs to do. Here, he's just kind of, like, reacting to what he's seeing. Like, he's watching on a screen this, you know, pre-recorded video. And so he's just, like, reacting to it, or, like, he knows what he's about to do. So he's like, I guess I'll make him cry. But he knows, like, when he's about to cry, so he just presses the button before. He actually does, like, move his thumb when he, like, as he turns, you can see his thumb is actually turning with him. Like, he actually took some time to make it look like he really is playing the game. And then the way Twitch people do this is just with a green screen, right? That's pretty easy to do. Okay, so here you see that old-timey big spotlight in the background here, but then now there's another spotlight. So that's how I know there's got to be two spotlights. He also has to turn that spotlight on. So over here, when he turns off the light, he probably reaches down and grabs like a remote and then turns the spotlight on and then, you know, finishes the scene. Stuff like this could so easily go unnoticed that like this spotlight, somebody had to turn it on, right? And he had to do it. So he has to be like pretending to get the bed ready, but then also like, no, okay, in this moment, I'm going to reach the thing, point it, put it down. Anyways, that's like a really trivial one that, I don't know, could have easily given him a lot of trouble because maybe the fucking remote doesn't work sometimes. Okay, so this one is similar to the Turning 30 song where he's listening to the instrumental of the track with all the background vocals and everything, and he's recording the lead vocals on that microphone, and then he's controlling all the lights and stuff live. On this one, he's not like doing the pedals, you know, he's controlling it with his hands with this device that we saw earlier. I don't know how that device works, but I'm guessing there might be some like presets or something where you just press and then it gives you the next lighting setup. So there's a few lights. You can see them in a second. So now he's got this one going this way and this one right here going that way. That's what's creating these shadows. This one's more like pinkish. This one's more yellowish. And you can see him, you know, triggering them here. And so now those two lights are turned off. He's got one in front of him that's pointing green at him. And there's got to be one behind him, like at his feet, pointing up at the wall, which has like the pink light. So like here, that light goes white, and then you get the rainbow lights in the back. So I'm guessing that, you know, he preset all of these lights to do these different colors depending, and then he has ways of telling it, now be white, now be colorful. You can see he's wearing his big, like, over-the-ear headphones on this one versus the last one he had the in-ears. Why? I don't know. Another super cool shot of some blinds. This is the other keyboard I was talking about that looks like a little more hefty, right? Like, these look like actual keys that feel like piano keys, and they probably have piano sounds that he uses to record and is probably uses this to play live. It looks like the lighting here is just coming from the window, which makes it look cool and natural. Here, it looks like he just got some like really cheesy DJ lights and pointed them at the ceiling behind him, and then he just has like a regular light pointing at him. I would bet that he's lip syncing this. I don't know why, I wouldn't have gone through the trouble of recording it for such a short little bit. This is a nice touch here. He goes and, you know, hits stop on his computer, and then here you see him hitting start on the laptop to get ready for this song. So all of these little green lights are just like a cheap little laser light show thing. Like, you can get stuff like this, which will make a bunch of dots or different shapes and stuff, which I think he uses on the Jeffrey Bezos number 2 song. $40, okay? Take some mushrooms and turn your house into a laser light show. So this is that keyboard that I was saying. I'm assuming here he's playing what you're hearing and that this is all really happening. Okay, so like drums and other sounds come in. So he has to be playing because he started with just vocals and piano, right? Right. So he has to be playing to a click. And yeah, so you can see headphone. There's a headphone wire right there. And he's probably using the in-ear ones. So he's listening to like a metronome. And he's playing along to it so that when the other instruments come in, they come in exactly when he was, when they're supposed to come in. It's possible that, like, he's not actually playing the keyboard parts because, like, he's afraid of fucking it up and he doesn't want to have to record it so many times. It's a little harder to fake the vocals because if you move your mouth a certain way, you know, and it's such a long shot that if, like, you don't lip sync it perfectly, it's going to ruin it. Whereas, like, nobody's that particular about how you're using your fingers on the piano. So then the question is, like, when you switch a shot here, it's like that first one where now are you still hearing him live and watching him play live? Or is this just like the audio from like the wide shot and he just like shot the entire song in this wide shot and that's what you're hearing and now he's just lip syncing along to that? Because if you're actually hearing what you're seeing, that means he had to splice audio from this take with this take and try to make it be seamless, which isn't impossible, but it seems like a lot of work. And then with all of these shots, it's almost certain that he's lip syncing, because why would you want to go through the trouble of recording the vocals on all of that and hoping that they all match up and it feels seamless? Okay, so here he uses the remote to turn that laser light off. It's kind of weird because here he uses that same remote, that white remote, to turn on the projector here, which I'm pretty sure that's, because here he has the projection and the little laser light show on at the same time. The spotlight's been there the whole time, so he's not controlling that, but that one remote could be, I don't know how he triggers all the light stuff. I don't know light stuff. Sorry, guys, I let you down for this one. That's here, cool. I think he just found this like cool light headband thing and couldn't figure out a way to use it, so he's like, I'll just use it for this part. Okay, another sick Jeffrey Bezos jam. I think that it's the same laser light show device that I showed you. Something similar to these, because they can do all kinds of crazy like shapes like this, and that's exactly what that looks like. Right? And then he has a green light. Well, it's the spotlight that's pointed at him, right? You can see it's the spotlight pointed at him. So he either had a green filter, because if he tried to make himself green in post, it would have made the background also green unless he did a lot of masking. And I don't think he did that. So probably he just put a little green filter in front of the spotlight to make everything in the spotlight green. This is just him in front of a light making a funny face. These are some trees. Here he just got the projector to project this background. And he's naked again. So all of this light is probably just from the projector. Projector's put out a good amount of light. It is possible that it's the projector, plus he had something else to brighten up his face even more. But I think the projector might be enough. And there's that SM58 again. Okay, so he gives you a little glimpse at this light, which is creating this like fake fireplace flickering effect. And here you can see it there. It's pointing at him in that way. And the projector is pointing over his head. And it looks like this. There's the light, right, pointing at him, illuminating him, putting a little warm light over here. Projector is projecting all this stuff. The projector's probably also projecting stuff on him, but we just don't see it because I don't think anything is moving in the projection. It's just like a still image. Okay, this song, I think the video is actually a sham. I feel bad because it's such a nice song. He's almost certainly singing into this microphone. That's that RE20 microphone. And you're hearing what you're seeing as far as singing. The question is, how did he record the guitar? Because when I listen to the guitar, it sounds really well recorded. And there's no microphones on the guitar, and the guitar isn't plugged in or anything. Okay, I went as far as taking a screenshot and brightening it up. And you can see, like, the guitar is not plugged into anything. And even if it were plugged in, acoustics kind of sound like shit. So there would have to be microphones like somewhere in this area. Like, to get good guitar sound, you point a mic either right there or right there, or preferably both, so you get stereo sound. And there just is no other microphones here. So the only way would be if this microphone is also capturing the guitar, but it's just not, because it wouldn't sound so good. I don't know. I think maybe like his guitar skills aren't that good, and it's all one shot, right? And so you don't want to fuck it up. And it's not like he would play the wrong chord or something, but you know, if you don't press the strings right, you know, it might not sound nice. And so maybe he went and like did like 5 or 6 takes of the guitar. He sliced it all up and made like one perfect guitar take. I mean, that's totally normal. That's what so many people do when they record. So he has like this headphone cable here, and he's listening through the headphones to the previously recorded guitar part, and then he's singing along to it, what he hears, and he's playing along to it as well on the guitar. But the guitar that he's playing, some of it will bleed into this microphone, but the well-recorded guitar is going to overpower it so much, and he's essentially playing the same thing, so it's not going to be like I hear something else happening. But I might be wrong. He might have actually played it perfectly, and I just don't know how he did it. Again, another fake little digital zoom. I mean, they work really well. I mean, there's a reason why people do that in movies a lot. With they actually move the camera in and out because you have like somebody to do that for you. It's just like, I don't know, a powerful cinematic thing that you can cheat really easily by just zooming in and post. Okay, this is another one where it's like, was this whole freak out thing that he does real or not? And one argument for why it could be fake is like, let's say he did freak out here and he's like, fuck this, I don't want to record this, right? Like, then why would he record himself sitting down? I guess he would have had to record this first, right? Because if he freaks out and he's like, fuck this, I don't want to do this anymore, he wouldn't go back and be like, okay, now I'm going to record myself sitting down. But it is kind of weird to record these kind of pickup shots before you record the real thing. So jury's still out on whether or not this whole freak out is real. That said, I guarantee you shit like this happened. I know that I've like recorded stuff where it's like I do 2 or 3 takes, I'm just like, fuck this. And I just like turn everything off, and then like I have to come back the next day. And here you can see that other light, which is almost definitely the other spotlight. It looks a lot like this one. $30 from A Cool with a Q. Here, the camera has a little microphone on top of it. I don't know why. He's clearly talking into that microphone. I haven't seen it any other time throughout the special. He still hasn't fixed the clock on the stove, which is a little upsetting. Okay, this song, I think, has three shots. It's got this close-up. Then he overlays it with like this more medium shot where you see a little bit of the background. You see some numbers here that you'll see throughout the video, and I'll explain in a second. And then he has this wide shot. And I really like how he did this shot. So what's happening is he has one light here, right? This little LED panel light. And that's pointing at his face. And then the camera is capturing just him in front of a blank wall, illuminated. And then the live feed from the camera is going to like the projector somewhere. And then that's projecting live back onto the wall what you're seeing. And so that the projector is what's mostly illuminating the room. This light is just illuminating him, and then the camera's capturing him. So it's like this whole chain of events. And then here, when he covers the light, he's preventing light from getting on him, which makes the camera not have anything to capture, so the projector doesn't have anything to show, and that's why everything gets really dark. And that's such a cool, creative way of, like, dynamically messing with the lights in such a clever way. So with these numbers up here, the projector is just acting like a monitor for the camera. So it just has like camera information. So I don't know what these numbers particularly mean. The battery's full. 29.59. I don't know if that means he's shooting in 30 frames per second, but then it'll be 29.57. Maybe it only has like a 30-minute recording time. Maybe the 59 means he's recording in 60 frames per second, which is like 59 point something. So yeah, I don't know exactly what these numbers mean, but it's just like camera information. The other thing is, why is everything blue? So it could be that he put a little blue filter on here, and so everything was blue, and then the projector's picking up blue light and spreading that. It could be that he set the projector to be, like, really blue, like everything was lit normally, and then, like, this was a white light, but then the projector is set to turn everything blue, and that's why everything's blue. Or it could be that everything was recorded, like, normal neutral light, like what you're seeing on my camera, and then he just did some pretty easy color correction. Making something all one color is pretty easy. So then here it's just like, you know, doing like opacity filters, right? Where you see multiple shots at once because you have each one at like a different level of see-throughness. Here now, if you look at the battery, it looks like the battery is low. You went from full battery to low battery. Maybe some kind of metaphor, or maybe you were just running out of battery. When he picks up the camera, you can see for a second, Logic Pro session open there. This one, it looks a little red, and when the track turns red, that means it's recording. And the one where he picks up the camera is the wide shot. So I would guess, you know, he could have recorded the wide shot as like the real vocal, and then the close-ups are maybe lip-syncing. I'm looking for a sign of headphones. Because if he doesn't have headphones, then he has to be able to hear the backing track, right, to sing along to it. I don't know if he's wearing, so he might, but he's not lip-syncing himself talking. I mean, that'd be kind of crazy. It could be that he has his in-ears in and I just can't see it. It's possible you could even put the music on the speakers, and yeah, some of it is going to get into the mic, and that isn't ideal, but it's not the end of the world either. Fucking super cool song, by the way. Fuck. Here he's eating a bowl of what looks like Lucky Charms? Okay, here's that, you know, light controller device, and you can see he's messing with the these ones, which are the multicolor ones. There's that disco ball. And there's the football. So I don't know a lot about lenses, but he's got these. They could be, like, super fucking nice lenses. This shot here, I mean, I think he just wanted to video himself recording that little melody, because you can see he is actually recording. You can even see the little MIDI dots. There, this is the video monitor, so he's watching himself. Like, him recording himself rummaging through the drawer, like, wow, that seems like he just wanted to, you know, show some of the behind the scenes. This, he wanted to actually show him recording this live. Like, he was actually recording that, what you hear. Okay, now I can't see the clock on the stove, but I can, I'm just gonna assume that he fixed it by now. And that's sort of the resolution of the movie. These shots of him, like, you know, watching himself, it's like, this is obviously part of, like, the bigger story, right? This isn't part of the performance of one of the songs. It's like he was trying to make a story about him making this thing, and these are the kind of shots that you need to show that. Okay, this one, This is another one where it's possible that he recorded this after he cut his hair off and his beard and then recorded it. Why would I say that? Because if he actually did record this before, it's well before, because, you know, his hair is like substantially shorter than it is for like everything else. And why would he like video, like this is like nicely lit. If it really was just like a test, like I don't think he would have made it look so nice. The other thing is that, okay, you're either hearing this version or this version, right? You can't be hearing both of them. And there's no like transition. So one of those he's lip syncing to the other one. And we can assume that he finished this song, finished writing it at the end, because it has bits and pieces of the other songs in the special that he was making throughout. I mean, it would require like so much vision ahead of time to like plan for all this. And kind of the beauty of making these kind of things is you figure them out, what they are, as you make them. And here, okay, this is, I think, like a middle phase, right? Like his hair here and his beard are not as long here. So there's like three versions of himself singing this song. So maybe he cut his hair halfway back and then cut it all the way back. Here you get some more cool glimpses into the behind the scenes. I love he just goes from this fucking smile to like, okay, God, do it again. And here he clicks on the iPad right there. And I don't know what the hell he was doing with the iPad. Maybe he was controlling some kind of playback? No, he has the laptop. I don't know what he's doing on the iPad right there. I mean, he presses it and nothing happens. So there's that monitor. You can actually see it's the F100 model. It's the one I showed you. Here's this shot, which I showed earlier. You can see he's got Adobe Illustrator installed. Zoom. iMessages with some notifications. You got to reply to those people, okay? You can't sacrifice everything for your art. I like this one where he has to spin the ball, turn off the headlamp, hit play, get set up. It's like, you just know he had to do that so many fucking times. Yeah, I'm still confused about when he actually recorded this song, which one of these haircuts he was actually in. But, you know, obviously you're listening to one. You're not listening to three different people sing the song. So it looks like he did it three times, you know, ostensibly in the beginning, middle, and end. But I believe middle, end, and then went back and did the first one. Here, just cool shots with cool natural lighting. Am I the only one who noticed, like, the alarm door sensor? I just, like, notice all, like, the home renovation stuff. Here, he just used a spotlight outside. Oh, and then he does this. That transition is kind of perfect. Yeah, he just matched the camera to the projection perfectly. And then that's the projection, probably just bouncing the projection light back onto him. I don't know what the producers would have helped him with this on. If it was just once he was finished, they kind of took the reins of the project. All of this stuff, like post-production and online editing, I think that's probably mostly stuff that needs to get done like for Netflix's standard. This is probably the only thing that really had an effect on what you see, the color correction, because I'm sure he knows how to do a certain amount of his own color correction, but there are parts that look like very, very polished. The sound credits are a little strange because like re-recording mixer, these are like film terms. And it's mostly like music. So I don't know who mixed the songs. Like, I don't know if he mixed his own songs. But like, yeah, mix stage is like, these are all like movie, like when people who mix dialogue in movies and stuff. So I don't know if any of these people had anything to do with like the music. Legal services is huge. Huge, dude. You gotta have the right legal team behind you and the right insurance. Or else how are you gonna focus on your art? These special thanks, I don't know who they are. Maybe they're people he just runs his jokes by. Hey, is this funny? What do you think? Okay, so that's that. What I really like about this from a technical aspect is how much like cheap equipment he used. A lot of that shit is stuff you can get on Amazon, and I'm sure he's got money, right? But getting a bunch of cheap shit makes you a lot less like precious about it, and you're just like, yeah, I'm just going to try it out. I don't know, maybe I'll use it, maybe I won't. You know, if you spend $1,000 on like one LED light, you're going to be really worried about using that light properly versus buying 8 different kinds of lights for $50 each, right? And then you just try stuff out and you just see what works. I think it's a huge part of why it's so creative. Just he sat in this room with all these toys and messed around. I mean, that's how you end up with like a laser light show while you're wearing a ghillie suit and singing about Jeffrey Bezos. So anyways, hope that was helpful. Go make some stuff.